Hi, I'm Todd LaBerge. I was just reading Steven Spielberg's next film that I'm going to be editing. He just doesn't know. Anyways, you're saying, Todd, I need my next family video edited. And I was chosen as the editor. Well, of course you were. You're the only one that knows how to run a computer. Kids. Anyways, I can help you in this tutorial.
Todd's going to teach the edit.
Now, you've heard the phrase, we can fix it in post. Well, sometimes that's not an issue. You want to try and get the shot the best you can the first time you got, no matter what goes wrong, because sometimes things are going to go wrong on set, and you just have to live and roll with the punches. But as an editor, it's important to always make sure that it's shot right the first time, because, you know, you could get something horribly wrong. And, yeah, always make sure you get it right the first time.
Let's cut.
What the?
The first thing you have to do is gather all your footage. It can take a while to look through all your tape. So here's a quick tip to save you some time. Just randomly choose several tapes or cards.
Now, if you have a lot of footage, you want to get an external hard drive. These things are going to hold all your footage and everything that you have. As you can see, I have several years worth right here. But you're going to want to format the hard drive to fit into the computer. So here we go. Just make sure you don't format the wrong one. Once it formats, it clears everything. Do you want to clear? Yep. All right, and I think I got the right one. Well, joke of the day is I formatted the wrong one. I'll be back. As we get ready to start our work, you're going to want to open up the program. Now, this may take a little while. Oh. Well, now that it's opened, you're going to want to start editing. Now, editing takes a long time. In fact, I started this video back in 2009. It's important you have a vision for your finished video, or else you might get a little lost in all the clips and slightly frustrated. Keeping a good blueprint or storyboard of your video can really help guide you. As we all know, the creative process can be rather daunting sometimes, but with music, you can make any creative project a fun project. You can also add transitions in between scenes, but it's important not to overdo it. Now, you want to keep it simple. Make it so you don't have so many effects that the audience is really confused. Because too many effects could mean too much headache for your viewer. What you need to do now is render the project. Rendering allows you to watch all your clips in order very smoothly with all the clips and effects on it. So, you click render. Render is going to take a while. I suggest you do one of these several things. A, grow a beard. B, summon Falcor and go on a never-ending story. C, go Breaking Bad, shave off all your hair and make meth. You can induce a coma. My friend Mark did. I haven't talked to him in 4 years. So low. Oh, looks like rendering's done. Now that you have the finished product, let's see how the family video turned out, shall we?
So strange, strange, life, it whispers, cry, a handshake, a soft, one that tears at your very soul, it gives birth to the universe.
Now that family video came out a-okay. So what you want to do next is export the video and burn it onto a DVD. So, it crashed. Sometimes you're gonna get these things where you crash and you wanna make sure you save your product. But I didn't save it, so. Excuse me.
Oh,
it's just that simple. Happy editing.